Friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we will discuss two switch forward converter. In last session we discussed single switch forward converter. In single switch forward converter topology, it uses one MOSFET, one IGBT, one transistor. In the turn on time, it allows to flow the current. It transfers the voltage in the secondary, and in the same duration this diode comes forward bias and it delivers power to the load. When it turns off, it stops the current. When it will stop the current, magnetic field will collapse and it will become in series to the applied voltage. So this transistor, this switching device, will take double voltage stress, applied voltage plus reverse EMF created by the collapsing magnetic field and the leakage inductance spike. So it will need approximately 2.25 times V in blocking voltage for this device, and it needs tertiary winding or reset winding in the same transformer, which will demagnetize the core. It is used up to, when we say two switch forward converter, in two switch forward converter we have this DC source, negative, positive, negative. This is the primary winding. One switch is here and it uses two switches, as it is defined by the name that it uses two switches, this one and this one. Secondary, primary and secondary are in phase windings. Here it will use rectifier, inductor, capacitor, RL. These two switches will work together. How it will work? In the turn on time, current will flow from this switch to winding, primary winding, this switch, positive terminal. It will create magnetic field, so magnetic field will directly cut this winding. Both windings are in phase. If this end is positive, because it is directly close to positive voltage, so positive end will here, negative here, current will flow in the secondary side. It will store magnetic fields because there is current flow, IL, load current and inductor current. When this turn on cycle will end and it will reach and turn off time, both switches will turn off. Now we need to reset the winding. We know there are different techniques to reset the winding. There is RCD snubber. In last video we discussed tertiary winding or reset winding, so it will reset the core. But here it uses reset diode. Cathode is connected to positive terminal, so this diode will remain reverse bias. In the on time, if you will see this diode, negative will connected to anode, positive to cathode, this diode is reverse biased. And another diode at this end, when this switch will turn on, positive voltage will reach to cathode, so it will reverse bias, and this end is connected to anode, so this diode is reverse biased. During turn off time, when the magnetic field will collapse, this end will negative, because in turn off time, when the magnetic field is collapsing, reverse voltage, reverse EMF will be created here. So this end now will become negative and this end will become positive. Both diodes will discharge in the supply line. If you see the voltage stress on this switch, here positive, then collapsing time this end will become negative, positive, then this end is negative. So one source, the second source. If here are 300 volt here, 600, plus leakage inductance spike. So the voltage stress will increase on this switch. But now we disconnected this switch. When it is disconnected, and if we see the voltage stress here, so just only the same voltage stress to the applied voltage, which is here, it will there on this point. And at the same time, it is being discharged here. So the transistor, the switching device, will remain in safe limit during off time. When this end will become negative, this end will become positive, this diode is reverse bias, so its magnetic field will collapse. Freewheeling diode here, same as buck regulator, this end negative, this end positive. In the on time, this end was positive, this end was negative, but now polarity reverse. This diode forward bias, so it allows charging current and load current. The main benefit here, that two switches switch at the same time, the duty cycle is less than 50%. In the on time, it will allow current. In the off time, switching device will take less stress with compared to this one. Let's see the timing diagram here. Q1 and Q2 switch at the same time, this one and this one. V primary is equal to V in. When the current will increase, primary current plus reflected back current, same as single switch converter, because we are driving the load in the same turn on time. So the current will reflect back to the MOSFET. It will cause to build IM, magnetizing current. During off time, the primary voltage will in reverse polarity, but that will be discharged in the same time. So we will receive voltage stress equal to V in. That is voltage across the MOSFET Q1 and Q2 that are here. So the benefit of this switch, that the transistor, the switch, the MOSFET will not dissipate high power with compared to single switch. And this forward converter provides more power. Single switch can be used up to 250 watt. It can be used up to 1 kilowatt. If you think this video is informative, then hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.